in case you didn't already know, I was actually a pretty fluffy chunkster for a few years. It was horrible. At my fattest, I was pushing just a little over 210. I looked like crap. I felt like crap. It was just a fat, funky period of my life, which is crazy because I was always a skinny kid growing up. I'd show up to meet my friends and they'd be looking at me like, yo, who's this fat guy? Where's Jordan? Did he eat him? I always aspired to have a superhero physique like all the ones I saw in all those movies, and obviously that lifestyle I was living wasn't getting me there, so I finally decided enough was enough. I didn't want to let the damage continue to get any worse. I wanted to get better, and I managed to dig myself out of the hole I dug myself into and get into the best shape I've ever been in. And I know a lot of people suffer and struggle with the same sort of situation. So today I want to share my top 10 dieting tips and tricks that I use throughout my journey to transform from fat to fit. So hopefully they can help you the same way they helped me. Let's get started. Planning. This is one of the most important factors of your meal plan and your diet. There's a quote that goes something like, a man without a plan for the day is lost before he starts. So I always planned out my meals for the day to avoid being in a situation where I didn't have anything to eat. Those are the types of situations you don't want to be in, because when you don't have anything prepared, you'll almost always be tempted into the ease of doing something easier that doesn't require any effort at all, like just grabbing something to go from a fast food drive-thru. So I'm someone who almost always cooks their own food now, but for those times I'm feeling lazy and don't want to have to do anything, I'll always have some sort of easy backup option in the freezer or the fridge or the pantry for those times I don't feel like cooking. Things like that have helped deter me from many trips to the drive-thru. Intermittent fasting. This is basically reducing your eating window every day to a set time frame, typically for 8 hours or less, so something like only eating from 12 to 8. The benefits of reducing your eating window is that it can naturally decrease your calorie intake without changing anything else about your diet, just by being in a tighter eating time frame, and it can optimize how your body uses your food fuel, like better hormonal stabilization, boosting your metabolism, reducing insulin levels, better muscle synthesis. It just overall helps optimize your energy better. All important factors in controlling your weight and losing fat. Intermittent fasting is something I've been doing all my life, and I didn't even know it was an actual thing until I really started getting into health and fitness. I've never stuck to a traditional breakfast, lunch, dinner type of daily meal plan or timing, and I think that sort of meal plan timing almost sets you up for eating when you're not even necessarily hungry. I've almost always skipped breakfast for the majority of my life. I'm just not hungry in the morning, and for me, I'm most productive in the morning. I do all my workouts in the morning, and I prefer to work out on an empty stomach fasted. I do all my work in the morning and find that after eating, I tend to lose a bit of that drive and focus. So the whole intermittent fasting thing has always felt natural for me. If you're new to it, my best advice is to keep yourself busy outside your eating window, whether that means working or doing whatever is most productive for you. You tend to eat when you're just sitting around, not doing anything, bored. So if you keep your mind and yourself stimulated, you won't even think about food until you're really actually hungry. And it'll make the whole intermittent fasting thing as simple and as easy as possible. Focusing on low calorie, high volume foods. This one's key because it'll allow you to eat more to weigh less. Nobody's gonna be satisfied eating a tiny portion of food. That leads to fat loss failure. If you wanna lose fat fast, the best food to help you do that are the kinds that you could eat a ton of but aren't many calories. When I started doing this on a daily basis, it almost seemed like the weight just started falling off. The best options for this are whole natural foods, mainly fruits and veggies, of course. So all those healthy leafy greens like lettuce, cabbage, spinach, all of that good stuff. Nutrient-packed veggies like broccoli, carrots, squash, peas, all of those. And a lot of fruit can be pretty low calorie too, like berries and melons. These are all highly nutritious and highly delicious low calorie foods that you can eat a ton of and get plenty full off of and stay full off of for way longer and for way less calories than other food choices. Now, I'm not saying you have to eat salads every meal of every day or consume any veggies or fruits you don't even like just for the sake of the benefits. I never did any of those things. Just pick your favorites and make sure these low-calorie, high-volumous foods are properly balanced into your meals to keep you fully satiated for longer off of less calories. It'll help keep your belly shrinking without all the rumbling normally attributed to weight loss diets. Eat more to weigh less is the motto here. home cooking. The majority of what I eat are all homemade meals. Learning to cook is an invaluable skill for weight loss and overall health and fitness. And if you don't know how, don't worry. I didn't either. You don't have to be a master chef. You just have to learn to cook what you like. I think the biggest mistake I made in those early cooking stages was taking on recipes that were too long and drawn out. It was overwhelming and way too frustrating. So I just took a step back, asked myself, what do I like eating? Burgers, burritos, stir fries, salads, smoothies, protein bowls. And then I started learning the simplest ways to make those, and then just went from there. And it definitely helped that those are all pretty simple things to make. Now it's all just muscle memory for me in the kitchen. So to avoid any kitchen nightmares, I definitely recommend keeping it to simpler, less time-consuming recipes, at least in the beginning. If I want something fancy that takes more than I care to put in to cook, I just go out and grab it from somewhere. I will say that seasonings are your best friend, and you'll learn what works best with what as you go along. I've got a few recipe videos already up on the channel to help give you some ideas for quick, simple meals, and I'll link them on the screen and in the description. Portion control. You can't get smaller if you're constantly eating big portions. Portions that are too big for you. Especially when they're comprised of too many of the wrong things. If you're focusing on those low-calorie, high-volume foods, it's really not a big deal. But for all the other types of foods, you want to really keep an eye on how much you're serving on your plate. Everything on your plate should be balanced. And a nice little mental trick is to serve your food on smaller plates. Serving the same amount of food on a smaller plate actually makes it appear to be much more than if it were served on a larger plate. Goes a long way mentally, trust me. And actually serving yourself on a plate as opposed to just eating family buffet style out of the serving containers will go a long way in helping deter overeating as well. No banned foods. This is a big one, because there's a ton of myths and misconceptions around it. There's way too many people out there who think you have to deprive yourself of your favorite foods in order to lose fat and lose weight. That is simply just not true. In fact, doing so could cause you to gain weight from the feelings of withdrawal. Completely restricting food, especially ones you enjoy, can be just as bad as overeating it. No food should be off limits, especially if they're your favorites. When you restrict yourself in that way, it makes your diet less enjoyable. And what do you do when you don't like something? You don't do it anymore. The key to a long-term, sustainable, successful diet is making sure you enjoy it. So instead of completely restricting certain foods, allow yourself to enjoy them, just in portioned moderation. It'll help keep you happy and help keep you going. Solid stockpile. No food should be off limits, but you definitely want to make sure the majority of your food stockpile is the right foods that are going to help you, not hurt you. So my best advice is to keep your fridge and pantry stocked with more whole, nutritious foods, and ones you actually like, of course, and less of those junky types of foods, especially ones that trigger you into uncontrollable binges. Like for me, I cannot have things like cookies or chips just laying around the house waiting to be snack attacked. Those things will literally trigger me to eat the whole container in one go. So if there's anything out there that causes you to eat mindlessly and uncontrollably like that, you may want to consider keeping them out of your house. Save them for when you go out. That's what I do. If I want a sweet treat, I'll get one fresh from somewhere instead of having a whole box of them tempting me at home. No cheat days. Now, while I've never made any food off limits, I've also never really incorporated cheat meals or cheat days either. And the truth is, it's because I've never really had to. When you set your diet up to be less restrictive, less limiting, and more flexible and more enjoyable like this, the balanced structure of it allows you to incorporate all those comfort foods and all those sweet treats you love so much in a way you won't ever feel deprived of them. It's when they're restricted and designated to only be able to be eaten on a cheat day that can actually kick cravings up and potentially cause you to binge out on any of them. At least that's what I've seen. It's very easy for a cheat meal to turn into a cheat day and turn into a cheat week, and for some people, a cheat life, sadly. So instead of limiting yourself to unload all these pent-up cravings on a cheat whatever and devouring a whole pizza and cake in one go, allow yourself to have a bit of them here and there. Have that slice of pizza one day, have that piece of dessert another. As long as you're doing everything else right, it ain't gonna hurt you. And it'll feel a whole lot better and a whole lot more guilt-free than the whole cheating approach. Drink a lot of water. This one should be self-explanatory. The majority of our bodies are made up of water. We need water for our bodies and our minds to function at their most optimal levels. They help with all the proper neurological processes and bodily going-ons. And under that umbrella is a lot of things that are needed to help you lose weight. The most important being staying hydrated. Proper, sufficient hydration helps boost your metabolism, cleanse your body of waste, acts as an appetite suppressant, and will help your body stop retaining excess water. All major positives for weight loss. I can't tell you how much I drink on a daily basis because it's so much. Just know that it really is a lot. There's always a jug or a mug of water right next to me that I constantly sip, refill, sip, and keep repeating that process all day long. Consistently accounting for calories. And last, but certainly not least, this should be a no-brainer, but one of the most important things I did to help get the weight off and keep it off is consistently accounting for all the calories I ate on a daily basis. On most days, this just meant me plugging it all into the MyFitnessPal app. Super helpful for ease of tracking calories, macros like fats, carbs, and protein, all that, and making sure I was getting sufficient amounts of micronutrients like vitamins and minerals, all that good stuff. And on days where I didn't feel like doing that, I just listened to my body. Something you should always do. Only ate when I was hungry, really made sure to properly portion control, stuck to my intermittent fasting window, and stopped eating once I recognized I was full. All the things I would normally do to help me count for my calories. The bottom line is, you can't manage what you don't track, and weight management all starts with calories in versus calories out. Eat more calories than you burn, you gain weight. Burn more calories than you eat, you lose weight. Pretty simple, right? The way you track that is up to you. Like I said, actually tracking and seeing what I eat with the help of MyFitnessPal has been the most beneficial for me. But if that's not your thing, you can definitely accomplish the same just by doing all the things we've already talked about. Making sure your plates are balanced with low calorie, high volume food, properly portioned and paired with a glass of water. Only eating when you're hungry and not when you're not. Those hunger cues are something I'll get way more in depth about in a future video because a lot of people misinterpret them. But whether you're counting your calories or not, you really want to learn to listen to your bodily cues and recognize when you're actually hungry or when you may just be thirsty or when you may just be bored, misinterpreting it as a hunger cue. Whatever you do and whatever approach you take, these 10 tips are sure to help supersize your game plan to help you get the job done.